Hey, yo, what's up? What's up? It's your boy Dion Odamuto. We're back with another video today. Watching Unreal at Gaming Beyond Dragon Ball Super Goku training for the top 5 strongest begins. Ultra Ego Vegeta versus Goku. Hey, look, this story is getting better and better by the manga chapter. So I'm trying to see what's in stores for today, man. So we're gonna get into it, bro. We're gonna get into it.
As our story continues on Beerus's planet, with Vegeta now being shown having to make his arrival, and from there being shown having to hand the bag on over to Beerus, that's when Beerus went on to address Vegeta by telling him, "Now let's see what's in the bag. You better not disappoint, Vegeta. You promised me something worth my time, so I'm expecting something delicious. What is this smell coming from inside the bag?" Beerus asks. "It's quite remarkable," with Vegeta responding, "The smell coming from inside the bag is from a food substance called fries, Lord Beerus. You will find these fries to be rather delectable, actually. I'm rather curious, Lord Beerus. You said there is much more to my Ultra Ego power than I am seeing on the surface. Tell me then, what exactly am I not seeing that needs improvement? Am I only scratching the surface of this Hakaishin power?" With Beerus being shown having to turn around by responding, "A lot, Vegeta. As strong as you are with that power of yours, you are still not able to beat me in battle. Maybe some of the other gods, sure, but I'm still far above your self-proclaimed Ultra Ego. Now tell me, what is this? It's wrapped in a weird foil, but it smells amazing." "I see. Oh, and that's called a hamburger, Lord Beerus. It goes hand in hand with those fries you saw in the bag, as out of nowhere from behind them, we then finally see how both Whis and Goku had made their way back into Universe 7, with both Beerus and Vegeta being shown having to turn around, with Beerus responding, "Oh, great. And look who showed up to ruin all the fun. You better not even think about it, Goku. This burger is mine." "Kakarot, where did you come from?" Vegeta asks. "What are you doing here?" With Beerus chiming in, "That's strange. Where exactly did you go? I wasn't able to sense your presence anywhere until you arrived. And you took Whis with you, didn't you? Where did you go, Saiyan?" "Oh, and don't shit. You dare lie to me either," Beerus shouts. "Now spill it." "Well, to be honest, Lord Beerus, I kinda had Whis take me to the Omni Palace and asked the Grand Priest to introduce me to the top 5 strongest warriors in the multiverse. They weren't quite fond of me, but they sure looked really, really strong, if anything." And Beerus loses it, as Beerus went on to shout, "You did what? What's wrong with you, Saiyan? Why would you do that?" "The top 5 strongest in the multiverse," Vegeta asks. "What do you mean, Kakarot? What did you do, Saiyan? Why would you call for them? Have you lost your mind? What happened?" As in the meantime, when going back to the Omni Palace, we then see how the Grand Priest seems to be speaking to someone, as this individual turns out to be none other than Budo, as the Grand Priest went on to tell him, "Thank you for returning, Budo. I think you know why I've called you to return, don't you? I had a feeling it would be about the mortal. Now, what is it that you request of me, Grand Minister?" With the Grand Priest responding, "I will be giving the Saiyan mortal a chance to test himself against you all," he says. "However, in his current state, he would quickly fall. And so, I've given the Saiyan 30 Earth days to prepare himself for battle against you. I will be holding an exhibition event
time,
where I would
though.
Like for you to be the Saiyan's first opponent," he says. "It would be a great way to see where the mortal stands among you all. Plus, it would allow for you to remove any battle rust that you may harbor, since it's been a long time since any of you actually had a worthy opponent to face off against. Consider this a test to see if he could pass," he says. "If you are to beat the Saiyan," the Grand Priest asks, "ads, then you will be rewarded with the Super Dragon Balls and having any of your wishes be granted." "We've been longing for a challenge," Budo says, "not a cakewalk. And with only 30 Earth days to improve, the Saiyan is doomed regardless," he adds. "But I will ensure that his quest for strength ends with me. Now tell me, if by mere coincidence I were to lose to him or he loses to me, then what happens to the loser of this exhibition event?" With the Grand Priest responding, "I've thought about this and came to the conclusion conclusion that all actions lead to very dire consequences. If you were to lose to the Saiyan, then you will step down as the fifth ranking warrior of the multiverse and be replaced. Your title will be void, but you will be allowed to keep your life. But if Son Goku of the seventh were to lose, then he will be destroyed without a trace. And you truly...
Oh, that's fucked up. Why he get destroyed? Nah, that's fucked up. That's hella fucked up. Nah, don't be doing my nigga Goku like that, man. That's crazy.
Do you think that I would allow for my title to be purged, Budo asks? Never. Would he be given the Super Dragon Balls if he were to win this bout as well? That is correct, the Grand Priest says. The winners will be given the Super Dragon Balls for any wish they desire to be granted. As in your case, he adds, the losers will lose their ranks and positions as the mightiest, whereas in Goku's case, he will be destroyed. In order for one's actions to be taken for what it is, there must come a price for each of them taken. Do you understand? As the days pass, I will announce the rules in place. With Budo being shown having to turn his head over his shoulder by responding, my title will not be revoked and I will not be beaten. I will destroy this mortal and have my wish granted. Then I would expect nothing less from the multiverse's fifth strongest warrior, the Grand Priest responds. In which, as Budo was then shown having to make his way back to his own respective portal, that's when he went on to continue, I don't know what you see in this mortal, but I will assure you that this will be the last thing this Saiyan ever sees. Oh, as I await the details and rules of this battle, just know that he will not get very far, he adds. I will learn as much as I can about this warrior before we meet, and once we do, he will be punished for his ignorance and be destroyed for his wretched arrogance. Oh, 30 days, Budo says. I will await for your response. And as Budo was then shown having to make his way back into his own dimension, it was from that point on where the Grand Priest had gone in observing his exit by saying to himself, and it will come to be, great warrior. I know this was what you wanted, Son Goku, and for your sake, I hope it was all worth it. I have no doubt in my mind that this will be a great battle that will be waged indeed, but I do hope you are ready for when that time comes.
I want to see how strong Goku get right now. Like, what? How far he gonna get? How strong he gonna get?
As all a while back on Beerus's planet, with an angered Beerus being shown having to grab onto Goku's gi and tugging him forward, that's when Beerus went on to shout at Goku by telling him, what gives you the right to go behind my back and jeopardize our universe, Goku? It's bad enough that you had to remind the Omni Kings about the Tournament of Power, and now you're out here asking to meet the five strongest warriors in the entire multiverse? You are going to get us all killed, Goku. I knew I should have destroyed you when I had the chance. You asked to find out who they were so you can fight them, am I right? And now look. And how exactly do you expect to be any sort of match for warriors like them if you only have 30 days to try and match even one of them, Vegeta asks. Well, that's the thing, Goku responds. I really don't know where to begin. Plus, I think the best way to go about things is to find someone to train with in order to test myself. You've completely lost your mind, Saiyan, so you can forget about asking me, Beerus says. Well, I have an idea then, Whis went on to chime in. Since you are both here, why don't the two of you go off and train for an hour and see how far you can go, he says. Vegeta would be the perfect fit for you, Goku. Vegeta is known for being very aggressive, so I think you can learn a lot from him that would aid you in battle against any one of the five warriors you will be facing. And didn't you also want to further your ultra ego powers yourself, Vegeta Whis asks? Then this would be a great way for you to also kick your training off, he says. For Goku, however, he doesn't have long, so we must not waste the time we are given to progress your training, he says. Well, Whis does make a good point, Vegeta, Goku says. I could learn a lot from you, and besides, it's been a while since the two of us really went at it, so how about it? Want to give it a go? It'll be like the good old days, Vegeta, with Vegeta responding, you want me to basically help train Kakarot for his big fight? Well, you can forget it. Figure it out on your own and find someone else, Kakarot. Aw, come on, Vegeta. Wouldn't you want to test your ultra ego power against my ultra instinct and see which one of the two is better? My training is reserved with Lord Beerus, not you, Vegeta says. You, on the other hand, will be reserved as the person who I beat in battle, not help train, he says. Oh, but shit. Then, that was when Beerus had gone in walking towards Vegeta by telling him, now hold it right there, Vegeta. On second thought, I think it's best to go and spar with Goku first. I want to see how good you are and where you'd need to improve once you come back, he says. But Lord Beerus, how will this, and don't go and embarrass my name in there either, Saiyan, Beerus shouts. Go and roughen him up while using this as a chance to see where your power ranks to his. After that, we'll go and resume your training here, Beerus says, but first I want to see the two of you brawl. Oh, this is going to be so much fun. Well, you heard the God of Destruction, Goku says. At least now I'll get to see how strong this Ultra Ego power of yours truly is. You're getting on my nerves, you clown. That's if you're lucky enough to make it into fighting those other warriors, you won't. This better be worth it, Vegeta says. To where as Whis was then shown having to create a portal back to Earth, Whis had then gone on in addressing both Goku and Vegeta by telling them, I think by having the two of you begin in the time chamber on Earth would be a good starting point, he says. Myself and Lord Beerus will be watching your duel from here. Oh, and Goku, I would encourage you not to use Ultra Instinct against Vegeta unless you truly need to, Whis says. Let's start by strengthening your other levels first. You should grow and build yourself up from the ground up and only use Ultra Instinct in case all else fails, Whis adds. And as for you, Vegeta, I would encourage you to think about Lord Beerus' teachings and use this Hakaishin power you have to the best of your ability in there, he says. To whereas we only then see how both Goku and Vegeta had now stepped on through in making their way onto Kame's lookout, that's when Vegeta went on to respond by telling Goku, this is just absurd. You just had to go and push it, didn't you? The top five strongest in the multiverse. You know you're going to lose, don't you? With Goku responding, well, maybe, but I really wouldn't know until I try. Besides, those were some of the craziest fighters I've ever seen. Shapeshifters, magicians, reality manipulators. It's just crazy. Oh, and off they go, my Lord Whis says. This should be a fun little match to watch, especially since they haven't trained with the purpose against one another in a very long time. Yeah. I'm going to die from heart failure because of Goku's actions, Whis. Thank goodness nothing happened. So they weren't interested, right? Of course not, Beerus says. Those four have better things to do. That Akuma and Budo, Yoshido, and Takira. What's the catch, though? If the Grand Priest is arranging for this to happen, what are the pros and cons of this event? Can Goku truly shatter all of his limits within 30 Earth days that will make some kind of difference? Well, the rules and rewards were not yet announced, but I'm pretty sure the Grand Priest will inform us with all of the details once he does, Whis says. And can he truly do it? Well, I guess we'll just have to wait and see how he progresses in order to truly tell, with Beerus going on to point at Whis' staff by asking, so they'll battle in the time chamber first. Though I agree with you pairing them off, but why Vegeta and not anyone else for starters, Beerus asks. Well, with Vegeta being more of the aggressor in this fight, Whis adds, he mirrors the top five strongest when it comes down to intensity. So who better than to bring the fight to Goku's doorstep than Vegeta when he's at his best, Whis says. Well, my money's on Vegeta, Beerus says, and he better not bring shame onto my name. Otherwise, I'll just destroy him and get on with doing the same to Goku after. True. So, no Ultra Instinct unless he truly needs it, huh? This ought to be good. It truly should be, Whis adds. These two have been neck and neck when it comes to trying to surpass one another, he says. As during this exact moment with Dende Shon appearing, that's when Dende went on to address Goku by telling him, oh, hey Goku, I wasn't expecting to see you and Vegeta here. What exactly are you guys doing here? Sorry for the sudden appearance out of nowhere, Dende, but me and Vegeta need to use the time chamber for an hour. It's actually really important, so I hope you understand. Oh, and try not to let anyone disturb us while we're in here too. Oh, thanks, Dende, we'll be out really soon. As with Dende Shon questioning this, that's when he went on to respond, hey, Vegeta, okay. Oh gosh, please don't destroy the time chamber from within. I hope you know that I'm not going to take it easy on you, Kakarot. And no Ultra Instinct unless you're truly out of options either, Vegeta says. You've been trying to adapt this power for a while now, so I want you to start using your lower levels and merge them with the principles of Whis' teachings. Oh, I know you won't, Vegeta, Goku says, and neither will I. Those warriors were unlike anything I've ever seen before, and to see them up close with my very own eyes inspires me to want to be on their level or beyond, Goku says, "I won't use Ultra Instinct unless I really need to, but are you sure you can keep up?" Goku asks. "I am more than capable enough of holding my own against you now that I've obtained my own unique power that's separate to yours," Vegeta says. Oh, meeting those warriors was one thing, but to challenge them was foolish. "You'll only get so far, but since you were there, tell me," he says, "who is the strongest?" With Goku responding, "Well, even if I'm able to just make them break a sweat, that would be enough for me," he says. What's crazy about it all is the Grand Priest is actually the strongest. He said that the other four couldn't match him, and if he's the ultimate goalpost that I need to surpass, then I'll do everything in my ability to try and do it, Goku says. "And you honestly think that you will be able to somehow pull this off within the 30 days you were given?" Vegeta asks. "You've lost it. This isn't a game, Kakarot. It's no surprise that there are warriors who exist who are far beyond what we are, but to assume matching them this early is a mistake. Well, I guess 30 days may seem like a reach, but I know I can manage to pull something off within that time," Goku says. "There was one advantage that the Grand Priest said I had that the others don't, and that's the power of Ultra Instinct. And if I can somehow figure out a way to evolve this power and go beyond my mortal body, then there's no telling how powerful I'd be. But I just need to try," as it was only right then and there from out of nowhere. To Goku's surprise, Vegeta had then gone in, immediately transforming into Ultra Ego, with Goku having to shout, "Whoa, this heat," Goku says, as through the Hakaishin aura, we then see how Vegeta was then beginning to step on through, as it was during this exact moment where Vegeta had gone in telling Goku, "If there's one thing that I won't allow to happen, is that I will make sure that you never leap by me in power again. Call it what you'd like, but Destiny has reserved the title of being the strongest for me." Wow, just look at him, Goku says. He's gotten so much stronger since the last time he used this form. Amazing. To where as soon as we then see how Vegeta had now come into his own by unleashing the power of Ultra Ego, that's when Vegeta went on to address Goku by telling him, "I don't consider this training to any degree because I could never find myself to ever train you of all people. So consider this a lesson that you will quickly regret, Kakarot. You are seeing right now is my all. Once again, just to remind you, I'm going to fight you as though I am aiming to kill you."
Hey, Goku, I don't know, Goku.
"So go on and hurry up," Vegeta shouts. "Use any form to start this off." To where as soon as Goku was then shown closing his eyes, Vegeta quickly went on to butt in by responding, "Hold on. No Ultra Instinct, remember? Unless you truly need it, which you will start this off by using one of your other forms first. Do what you did against Granola on Planet Sorrel and combine your power and abilities," Vegeta says. "And you better make it count, too. I'm no stranger to Ultra Instinct speed, so this ought to be a pretty good warm-up before I beat you into submission after you decide to finally use Ultra Instinct. Now hurry up," Vegeta shouts. To where as Goku was then shown having to ignite the powers of Super Saiyan God, that's when Goku went on to respond to Vegeta by telling him, "Well, alright then, Vegeta, I think I'll try out Super Saiyan God and see how far it can take me against this destroyer power you've got. So I guess I'll do the honors and kick this off," he says. "Let's do this." And as soon as Super Saiyan God Goku was shown having to dash towards Ultra Ego Vegeta, it was only as both Beerus and Whis were watching where Beerus went on to respond, "So he's starting things off by using Super Saiyan God, is he? Not a chance, Whis. If Vegeta doesn't smash him within the matter of a few moments, then I'll be shocked," he adds. "The only advantage that Goku may have while combining these powers is speed. A smart tactic, but an amateur one at that," with Whis responding, "Although Goku has shown great improvements by merging Ultra Instinct with his lower forms, this will be a great test to see how much Goku's Super Saiyan God power can endure before transforming higher." And as soon as we then see how Super Saiyan God Goku had gone in making contact by punching Vegeta in the face, without even having to move a muscle, Vegeta from there had gone in responding to Goku by telling him, "You've got to be kidding me." "Seriously," Goku says, "not even a flinch? You are going to have to do much better than that if you wish to even cause me to feel pain, let alone win," Vegeta says. "This was what you wanted, right? To wage war against the strongest, didn't you? Well, last chance. Give it everything you've got," and that was exactly what Super Saiyan God Goku had done, because the moment Goku had once again gone and kneed Vegeta in the face and then being shown having to back up, that's when Goku went on to respond, "Oh man, I knew Super Saiyan God wasn't going to be effective, but I wasn't thinking it was going to look this bad. You are nowhere near ready," Vegeta says. "Think fast." As before you know it, within the blink of an eye, Ultra Ego Vegeta had gone and speed blitzing towards Goku and uppercutting Goku in the stomach as Beerus went on to respond, "Oh, now that's what I'm talking about. Did you see that, Whis? Why wasn't Goku able to move out of the way if he's merged Ultra Instinct with Super Saiyan God?" As Whis responds, "I did. Well, I think it's because Goku is more than likely thinking when he should be empty in battle," he says. "That plus Vegeta appears to be much faster than Goku's Super Saiyan God Ultra Instinct reaction speed. And as soon as Goku was then shown having to drop on down to a knee and reverting back down to his base form, it was from that moment on where Vegeta went on to lecture Goku by telling him, 'Look at you, Kakarot. You're already right back down to your base form, and the fight had only lasted for about 60 seconds. Now imagine what those other warriors would do to you, and that was an easy one too. Adapt and stand back up. Quit wasting my time,' Vegeta shouts. 'You better start figuring things out, and you better do it fast, because I have no intention to drag this out any longer than it needs to.' So you have three options," Vegeta says. "Quit and exit the time chamber right now, go back into strengthening your lower forms, or use Ultra Instinct. Time's ticking," Vegeta says. As in the meantime, all a while on a distant planet called PA99N2, we only Frieza. Then take a look at seeing as to how Frieza seems to be traveling through this deserted desert by himself. As with Barry Blue also being shown having to stay in direct contact with Frieza, that's when Barry Blue went on to tell him, "You're close, my lord, just about 2 kilometers north, but are you sure about doing this, Lord Frieza? It's been a very long time and there's no telling what this interaction is going to be like once you find him." "Wonderful," Frieza says. "His energy is faint, but I'm starting to sense him. Worry not, Barry Blue. This will either go one of two ways. Either he listens to what I have to say and offer him, or he will die. I'm sure his hatred for me has not been extinguished after all these years, but now is certainly not the time to dwell on old memories, especially if he wishes to regain what he believes was rightfully his." And there it is, Frieza says. How exciting. As he now seems to be staring at the entrance to a gigantic cave, that's when Frieza went on to continue, "I'm quite surprised he was able to hold out like this for all of these years without anyone being able to find or detect him." But then, as from the entrance of the cave, we then see how a blast had just gone in, barely missing Frieza's head, as Frieza went on to respond, "My, my. Well, that was close. You grazed me, so you know I'm here. It's been a very long time, hasn't it?" Frieza says. "It's good to see your aim is just as dangerous as I remembered it being. But is this how you treat your guests? And here I thought you'd have a bit more class than that," Frieza responds. "I never thought you'd be living in hiding like this," he says. "I thought you actually died a very long time ago. So your will to survive is quite admirable considering what happened," he says. "But I didn't come all this way to wage war with you. As a matter of fact, I come alone. There is a matter that I would wish to speak with you about that would certainly be of great use to you if you are willing to listen. I came here for aid. There is a matter which involves two Saiyans who have survived Planet Vegeta's destruction, and their very existence poses a great threat to us both," Frieza says. "They are unlike anything you remembered the old Saiyans being like. So if we are to live to see another day, then their deaths must be seen through until the end." As from within the shadows, the individual that Frieza was speaking to went on to respond to him by commenting, "You've got some nerve coming here. Your business with these Saiyans is none of my concern, little brat." "Oh, but it will be soon if they are not dealt with," Frieza says. "I see you're still very angry at me for what happened. I could make it all go away if you were to hear me out and listen to my offer. After all, we're family, and there's no other bond that is greater than a brother's. Right, Cooler?" As it was only right then and there during that moment where the Beyond Dragon Ball Super story of the top 5 strongest warriors in the multiverse manga chapter number 3 special then comes to a close. Now, it only appears as though after all of these years, Frieza had now finally found Cooler on this remote planet that was for whatever reason seemingly living in hiding by also now being shown having a vendetta against his younger brother Frieza. But the $1 million question now is, what is Frieza doing on this planet, and what is Frieza's...
Yeah, what the fuck is Frieza doing on this? Man, like, that story crazy. I ain't gonna lie. That story getting better and better by the chapter. I can't wait to see what's to happen, man. Like, it's so good. The story, like, it's building up perfectly. I'm like, I want to know what's coming next. So, you know what I'm saying? Make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe. And I'm gonna make more. I'm gonna push them out like that. I'm gonna push them out. Pew, pew. You know what I'm saying? So y'all let me know what y'all think about the story down below. And I'll catch y'all next time. Peace.